Happy Friday, homespun friends. I'm coming to you today from my kitchen. It's very rainy here in our corner today. It was rainy yesterday. It's been kind of tough to stay inside and stick it out through all the rain, but I did get a lot of chores done. And one of the things I wanted to do was show you how I make oatmeal the night before breakfast. When my children were small, they were difficult in the mornings. They did not love to eat breakfast very much. I would make cheese toast or try to get them to eat even cold cereal that they loved. In the mornings, they just didn't want it. Now they loved fried breakfast, the eggs and bacon and that sort of thing, but they wanted that for supper time. They didn't want that for breakfast. Matter of fact, just getting them to eat it all was a challenge. But one of the things that I think settles well in your stomach and provides a great nutritional start for the morning is oatmeal. And so if you can get that ready the night before and have that ready first thing in the morning when you get up without having to do a lot of extra work, then it sure does make it nice. It makes it easier to go through your day. So let me show you how I make my oatmeal in my crock pot. Okay, friends, here is how I make my steel-cut oatmeal. I start the night before with my crock pot. Here I'm using a smaller crock pot than I would normally use. I use it expressly for the purpose of making, it might be a rice or oatmeal because it's such a great size and you're not going to fill up a large crock pot with oatmeal. So this size, it really works well. And what I do is I take these steel-cut oats. Now, one of the reasons that you use steel-cut oats in your crock pot is because this cut, while it's nutritionally the same as the rolled oats, it is made and cut in a different way. It makes it a little bit hardier to stand up to the overnight process. And so if you can buy steel cut oats, that's what you're going to need to make the oatmeal overnight. And I got this particular brand. You know I'm a fan of Aldi. I got this at Aldi for a really good price. It was like half the price that it is in other grocery stores. And so I know that they still have it there because I buy it regularly. Check and see if your Aldi has these oats, these steel cut oats. That's what I use. Then I put about a half cup of the steel cut oats over into my crock pot, and with that I put about 3 cups of water. Now some people like it really thick, and some people like it better if it's more liquidy. And so you'll have to kind of perfect this on your own. If you make it one morning and it's a little bit too runny for you, then you know the next morning to put in, you know, less water in it the night that you make it. But typically I can put in about 2.5 to 3 cups, and it really does the job. It's perfect in my crock pot. So you try that, about a half cup of oats to about 2.5 or so, 3 cups of water, and then stir it up really good. And I set that on my crock pot to warm. And I hope that your crock pot has that setting on it. If I try to make it on low, it gets really too dry. It's not a good setting. So try to turn that on warm and leave it overnight. I usually do this right before I go to bed. And then in the morning when we get up, the house smells so good here in the kitchen and everything is ready to go. And then to that, we add whatever we want to. You can add some honey if you have that, or you can add maple syrup. You can add raisins. My husband loves the brown sugar. You can add nuts of any kind. One of his favorite things to add is the cinnamon. And you can add fresh fruit. You can have blueberries, strawberries, bananas, anything like that you want to add into the oatmeal. And you have your breakfast ready to go immediately when you get up.
This particular method of making oatmeal has worked very well for me since everyone's running around in the mornings when they get up. And it just is convenient. So I hope that if you have made it, you will share below how much you like it and what you put in your oatmeal. If you have not made it and you try it, let me know how it turns out for you. It just makes morning so much easier. I pray you guys have a blessed day, and I'll talk to you again soon. Bye-bye.